अभी ठीक हो गया कोई
बेटा यूज़ करो।
मैं कहीं जाऊँगा तो नहीं
भाई। फर्स्ट रूम आई थी देर रात। जैसे आई शुड शेयर मेरा फर्स्ट फाइव नॉट यूज़ करना पूरा भर गया। इधर नहीं
है।
जैसे एक बार
Thank you. Good afternoon, friends. It's my pleasant duty to extend a cheerful welcome to you all. We are delighted to have you here to participate in this talk hosted by the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication and Stargazers, the only astronomy club in NCERT. Today's topic is Large Area X-ray Proportional Counter, which is under AstroSat and Blackbird system. AstroSat is India's first dedicated astronomy satellite with five instruments on board, namely SSL, Luminosity, SST, LHCC, CZ-ER, to cover the visible, near UV, far UV, soft X-ray, and hard X-ray regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. It is scheduled to launch on board the PSLV in October 2015. Black hole system and LHCC, that is Large Area X-ray Proportional Counter, which is the key instrument on board AstroSat, will be presented in today's talk. We are deeply honored to have Professor J.S. Yadav with us today. Professor J.S. Yadav has been working at Tata Institute of Fundamental Research since November 1982. He has worked in many areas which include anomalous cosmic rays, ultraviolet cosmic rays, X-ray flaring and X-ray outbursts in black hole binary, persistent and transient radio waves in black hole systems, etc. He worked on Luna 16 and Luna 22 moon samples during 1982 at GRNR, USSR. Professor Yadav worked on another instrument, a TIFR instrument that was flown in spacecraft 3 of NASA during 1985. He was visiting scientists at California Space Institute, San Diego, USA, Munich, during 1987-89 and worked on gamma ray spectrometer on NASA's Mars Observer mission, which was launched in September 1992. He also worked on Indian X-ray astronomy experiment that was launched on IRSP-3 in 1996. That is Israel mission, which discovered flaring activities in any black hole system for the first time, along with NASA's IRST-PCN. Our present Professor Yadav is responsible for the development of Large Area X-ray Proportional Counter, that is LAXPC instrument, which is a major pillar of AstroSat, India's first science space mission. All the LHCC detectors and related packages have successfully completed all the tests during 2013 under his leadership, and now integrated with satellite and ready for launch at Sriharikota in next 20 days. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a huge welcome to Professor J.S. Yadav.
Thank you very much for this nice I also thank the principal Dr. Prachi and Dr. Rao for inviting me here. So I will try to now do just this how this talk goes. There is a good news that, of course, now, as you know, since launch is say within next 20 days, 28 September. The last test, whatever possible, we can do in lab. Basically, you can put your hand on the instrument, that is the last time. It was 25th August. After that, you will not be able to touch it. That test was done on the 25th August last month. And yesterday, there was a huge meeting. There was all these elaborated meetings. Okay, you people are from the engineering branch, you know. When it is satellite, once it is launched, nothing is in your hand. What you have done before that, that is only in your hand. So when this review is there, there are all sorts of panels from the communication, hardware, thermal, all those things, and they have to clear. So I'm happy to tell you that it is clear now today. In fact, I was there in Bangalore yesterday only, so I came back. And I'm telling you this story so you can understand that how much time I would have put on this talk. So I would like to do justice on this talk in the sense that why, number one, if I take to your level what type of interest you have, then I will put in following way, little bit history, what is like these type of missions worldwide. Okay? And then what is perspective in India? Then if it is delayed, why it is delayed? And then I will come to what are the sites which we study. Now I'm talking about in astronomy term. In the sense, in our galaxy or outer galaxy, what we study, but why you study in that, okay? So I will not take you people in deep. I will just be giving only the whatever popular type of thing. Mostly I will try to do popular, okay? But then you know, since we are scientists, we always go deep somewhere. But most of the time I will do. And when I am coming to the science, there are very broad science this satellite came to. It is India's first full-fledged science space mission. This is the first. So we have a lot more problems with communication, with technology, and so on. The technology part I will highlight here because you people are engineers. The other part, like science, so I will take only few examples, try to be popularized within a way where you can concept, few concepts only. That will be really symbolic. I will be not talking about this. Of course, when we are talking about AstroSat, its capabilities, it's just the large area proportional counter, will be the largest in the world. Not today, only for today. It will be remain like this for the next 10 years. That is what we expect. So there are some other plans right now which are supposed to be launched in 2024. So till then, this will be the largest facility in the orbit. So now with this, I will come to my introduction part. And you know that how to move this slide? Next. This is going to be this one, I suppose. Okay. So before this, let me just go straight. What we study is the X-ray. And X-ray is very high energy. You know, people go for X-ray, right? For body and very, very good problem. So what we are habitual, our eyes are only sensitive to optical. So if you see the history of optical, for centuries people are doing optical studies. I mean, there are observations, even Galileo in the 16th century, he first designed very small telescope and he discovered some moons of Jupiter and so on. Okay, but in X-ray, you need very high temperature, that is roughly, this is the point of.
So that's not the point.
Oh, this is not the point. All right. So for X-ray, if any rod or anything other way, I will talk like this. So X-ray is here. You need millions of UV temperatures. And there lies the importance of this. So the importance of this, that this type of source, wherever it is visible, I will come to the popular level when we talk about, they really control even the galaxy. setting with star formation, those things. Because the energy is so huge that it can spread all over the galaxies, even outer galaxies. So it controls. So that's why this study is important. So here I'm talking about now what is the problem with this study. Why? You will know that it is hardly whatever done during last 50 years only. I'm talking worldwide, not India, worldwide, which is whatever progress has been done during last 50 years. So if you see, most of the radiation, this is our atmosphere. And if you see the X-ray, thank you, almost all. Yes, who is speaking? I will talk to you after, but I am in a talk now. I will talk to you later. I am giving a talk right now. I'm sorry. So, see, X-ray is here. Everything will be absorbed in atmosphere. You can't see anything or not. And that was the one reason why it has not been studied here. Okay, like optical, everything comes here, okay? This is the green one. That's what we can see. Quite a bit here, yeah. Okay. Yeah. So this was the, so this is the reason why you need this all series should be done in the orbit. This half year to go. And that makes the problem. So I'm coming to the history now of this. So if you see, first X-ray was observed after World War II. There was spear rockets with these US allied forces. And some of the scientists, they just fired and put some counter, and they found there is some X-ray from the sun. Now, if you know, sun's temperature is hardly 6,000. Right? So X-ray should not be there. So there was really not more problem why it is so. But of course now people understand, but that was the first observation. So I'm talking about the observation of X-ray. And you need to go to in space, that is what I want to say. And this was the real first observation. And that was something like in 62, where the Balconi, he puts on rocket again, a small proportion counter, and he detects the source. This one, this is huge, very, very bright source in the sky. And I'm talking about 62. And 62, because this was flux was not so high on this one, so people thought they could explain by some source. But still, people were not knowing at that time. You think about 62, that you need black hole, because black hole was not observed by that time. And for this, of course, he won Nobel Prize after 40 years, so 2002. Okay, for that work, whatever, really, this was first time in instrumentation in X-ray. Now, corresponding thing in India, of course, something like 30 years or more. Okay. So from this particular type of instrument, this is IXA instrument, here from JFA, and this was a small proportion counter. So you can see small count 1, 2, and something here. Okay, and they really it was a piggyback experiment. If you don't know the piggyback concept, it is following. You have a big satellite. It is a very costly venture. So what you are being given that, okay, you make a something payload, something like 50 kg. My main payload is something like say 800 or so, something else. But I will fly 50 kg or thing, okay. So in that case, what happens that our Indian missions, most of the missions, they are Earth-bound. They are looking at Earth most of the time, okay. Whether it's transmission or whatever is scanning or whatever they are doing. So when we want our observation, we have to move the satellite up and to look at the sky. So that's why they were giving something like 2 months time per year. And that was the really, but it's still in the 90s. So that was the history in India of this X-ray. So with this history concept, now I'm coming to, I have told you only two things that, one is that the X-ray need very high temperature. and from where that high temperature can come. Still, I have not told you that black hole concept was not there, and say theoretical concept was there. I am coming to that point. So, the basic concept from your point of view, where we don't need really too much physics, is that the most easiest definition is that if you have escape velocity, that is for Earth is 11, Sun is 42, so you want to fire it apart. But if you have some place which is called black hole, velocity, escape velocity should be velocity of light. So in other way round, what does it mean? I am saying nothing should escape. So if I say if light cannot escape, nothing should escape, and that is what is a black hole. And now coming to the class level knowledge. So if you take that thing size, now suns will be, if you want a black hole, it should be 9 kilometer, or you need 3 suns mass, 3 suns and together should be 9 kilometer. And now you know it is million kilometer, its size, sun size, okay. So that will reduce so much. Sun mass, one will be 3 kilometer, and Earth will be 2 millimeter. Earth will look like this.
Now, can you have concept, what does it mean? I can talk many things, but do you understand this part? Okay. I will put other way around. You have a gas, okay, cool it. What will happen? Go to liquid. It will have less volume. You again cool it. It will become solid. Again the less volume. Now what is next after this?
So most of our bodies, plenty body like Earth, Sun, they are solids. Right? There are also some gaseous things, but most of them are things. But what will happen next? Now, next is if gravitational force is still high, first it will degenerate electron. So it will break the atom. Provided your gravitational force is high. And gravitational force is coming gmm upon r square, whatever that mass of the body comes in picture. But it is not only mass, R also comes in picture, how far away you are. If it is very close, force will be very, very high. And that's why you need compact object. That's why you need that. So, the first, when you break the electron degeneration, that is atom, proton and electron is moving around. If you break by this, that will become neutron star. So, I will be talking about neutron star also comes in the compact object category. Okay. Now, then, if you still break further, because in nucleus you have what? Proton and neutron, right? Still you break, because your gravitational force is still high. Then you don't know what it will, but density will be something like 10 to the 16 gram per centimeter square. U density, okay. And that will become the black hole. So this is the one concept, okay. This is the one concept. I will come back to the other one. If anybody has any doubt about this, okay. So the basic idea of all this came from these various scientists. That was 20s and 30s. Okay, Einstein, of course, they start with the gravitation theory. And Chandrasekhar, okay, from India, of course, he gave the neutron star. When things will become neutron star. He says you need at least 1.4 solar mass. Okay. And then there are other ideas. I will not go deep into that because I want to keep little electronics part and other part more thing. So I will be only touching the particle. Something is somebody is interested can ask me. So these are the basic limit, but this was known in 20s and 30s. This should be there. Observation came only in 60s. Not even in 62, which I showed you the first slide, where somebody from the US, like when he flies that rocket and they saw that there is a very high flux X-ray. One can really explain with I can take 100 solar mass of a star, very large star, and something by doing, you know, scientists always do something and they can produce X-ray for it. But in 60s, late 60s, around 67, there were very bright sources in the sky, not in our galaxy, it is outer galaxy. So you know the distance from there to there. You can measure the in optics, optical of course at that time. In optical you can measure.
hear without it finally. Can you hear me or no?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. It's better, right? All right. So they saw that in the sky that there is you can calculate the total amount of the energy coming out. It is coming out from a point source. So if you measure the point source, the energy was huge because it is a long distance. You know that from with the distance, I'm measuring such an energy, it will be multiplied by R square factor. So it is a huge energy. Now, there was no known mechanism by which you can produce the energy in a point source. Now, what we know about energy sources, for example, what are the mechanisms we have? See, we have, for example, of course, by chemical burning only they have some energy, right? And now you have this nuclear like reactors, right? Fusion and etc. you can have. Okay, but that will not be enough. These two concepts, if you take like the sun burning fusion, that will not make that much energy. It has huge, much factor. So, I'm now coming to that factor. So, this energy again comes from the same thing which I said, the size of the body. So, total energy available. Suppose something falls on the surface, how much is the energy? If I say at a certain distance it has come from infinity and falling on this surface, how much energy it will gain? It is simply gm upon r. So now how this energy can be maximum if you reduce the r, right? And when r comes in, say, if I say you have a electron degeneracy or the nucleon degeneracy, you get very small radius. So much, and then energy comes, this delta E is equal to this one. All right, okay. I will come back to this concept again. So this is what it is, the shown here. This is the equation. This I will not go too much detail. Mass is falling onto this and slowly heating up due to this energy is gaining, and this is what ready, and this is what we measure. It does a little bit more than this. I'm just showing you the concept right now. So the comparison of the efficiency of this energy mechanism. So here this is for our nuclear fusion, 0.7%. And if you put 1, that will give you, right, 0.7%. Okay. And this is what you are getting for 10 kilometer or something like that. Half factor will come, so at least 50%. Okay. Now, I have not used very great formula in this, okay, it is very simple formula. But you have to put just Gm upon R and half mc squared, and you will get this, okay. That is the ratio that V you need, the density of the things to go out. So, from there, 50%, of course, if you do refine on those things, put more electricity correction, you will know that neutron star will be something like 11%. While black hole will be something like, so there are more corrections there because you spin in those things. This radiation mass can go to much lower radiation, but there is a concept of stable orbit where it mass can be stable for some time and it can radiate. From there comes something like 11 to 43% efficiency radius. So 43 is a very large factor. You don't have anything which can do here. Sun is doing something like 0.7%. So you can think about the efficiency. So one more concept I want to, I think, I hope you are understanding this part. I have to do a little bit because I will be coming to the now next instrument. Okay. Before that, I just want to explain these things. Now, nature also has a controlling system. See, when you have a such high efficient mechanism, you put the more fuel, more energy will come, then what will happen? How to control? Can anybody think about this? See, this is the efficiency of the thing. Mass is falling from other companion, what we call companion. You have a compact object, black hole, and mass is falling from somebody. It is in fact your gravitational capturing the mass from there. Okay. So now what is that mechanism? Mechanism comes at very high. We don't really, in day-to-day life, we don't see such thing. But what is happens when radiation pressure becomes more than gravitational pressure, it will throw up. And that concept gives the what we call it Hamiltonian velocity. So this is the efficiency L Hamiltonian
it is coming out. This is the vector 38 m upon x squared of mass. See, there is no other vector except mass in this. If I know the mass, I can calculate what is the maximum luminosity I can have from any of the. So you can understand this thing that I am looking at the sky. In this kind of concept, while you can live 60, you can say this is a black hole. Okay? And this is the concept which also shows that luminosity cannot go higher than this. So this is my theoretical ideas, but really we'll do the practical lecture. So this was the one concept, and so now I'm coming to the instrument. So we want to study this X-ray. Coming to the instrument, I would like to say that these are so much energy in a galaxy, usually all the galaxy, whatever we know, and that is very large number, we're talking about 10 to the 11 galaxies, okay. So each of the galaxy, most of them have very massive black holes at their center, and there are a long, large jets from there, which really puts the energy all over the galaxy. And that contracts the galaxy very much. Even our galaxy has a black hole at the center, whose mass is something like 2 × 10⁶ solar mass. It is a little lighter than usually what we see, billion solar mass. It is a million solar mass, black hole. Now I am coming to this. So this is India's first instrument, first mission. And there are various institutions. KFR of course providing few instruments. UIT is from IAEA. So there are other institutions also who are part of this. The overall mission wise is like this: 650 km. That is orbit. Mass is around. Now we know this figure is reduced. That's why some figure that we are taking in this thing. It is 15, 10 or so, and always a few concepts for you people are different technical people. So I will share some of the things. When you have a rocket, and suppose your rocket is supposed to launch 1550, okay, and if I don't put that much mass, the trajectory and those things, all calculation I have to redo and some problem. So what they did, people always put piggyback experiments. So this will be also carrying 3 piggybacks from 3 different countries because of the mass is something like 15, 10. And other things I will not go through. Some like 5 is the things what we expect now. This is September 28th, it fits now. It is up to 5 to 10 years we are talking about power and those things of this from global weather. And this is what comparing to other one. So even this is US mission, RX, NASA mission. Even such missions, they really take something like 10, 15 years because this is huge money on the first planning. So what are the basic stage of the missions? Basic stage is first you send a proposal, a small one, and they will give you some token money. You prove that your idea is wrong. And then major part of the money comes, but it's still not happening. So first when you develop the what you call an engineering model or proto model and prove that whatever you are proposing that can be achieved. Okay. Once you do, then they what they call a critical design review, that is done, then final yes for the go ahead for the flight networks. So that's why it takes so much time. You may hear it is for our society also taking 10 or 12 years or so. Now these are the 4 missions now, okay. So you get in the beginning of these 3, these in fact 4, they are X-ray mission. And this is some sort of, you can say, a eye in the sky, looking always moving around all the time. So it is not in a real sense a detector, but it is more like an eye in the sky. If there is any new transient, it will get very fast. So it like operating a whole like this, moving like this, and there are 3 identical moves all directions. So 180 degrees they can cover the sky and they can tell very fast if there is anything new. Other these 3 are X-ray one and this is you. So this is the first Indian multi-wavelength satellite from optical to hard X-ray. Okay. Okay, so now I will cover only this leg species. And this is very well, I think the non-emitting type of thing covers very wide range of energy and very fine resolution. And so I will come to this and let me few things quickly. So one, we have the goals of this. So I will only highlight the goals which is connected with engineering. So for example, I will not talk about how we reduce the breakdown. Here you are, from even point of view, your goals are redundancy. Because you cannot touch the density bond, you cannot touch it. So critical, for example, where I have an electronic card, I will come to all electronic card also. The particular one, which is the mind of the thing, where I have a logic, I will classify the, or I put into different bins by what type of particle has come, what are the electrons. In single card, you have two different identical circuits. So in case of one is the problem, you can do another. That is the one. Second, like previously I told you, this leg species has a three identical units. They are completely separate. If something happens in one, second will not be affected. That is another redundancy. Third is, of course, then the basic thing, you have to, in a space, it is very costly. You can put it half kg. So you have to see that what is your weight is given and what you are eating. So that is very, very much optimized. The other point, probably I will give a few more minutes on this, because we faced when we were testing this. Test the result I will show you later on. But when you were testing, there are something, many of the things. You know capacitors, right? Capacitors, they are biased, okay? Now suppose we are using hundreds of capacitors, not one, okay? Now capacitor, somebody, now people are working day and night and problem happens, okay? And if you see first capacitor, once they will put in the whole bag, only then they will be done. And after some time, not before, not in electronic laboratory. So we face such type of problem once we reach there in the lab, when we test it in the vacuum in one suddenly. And when it done, then whole history starts. Okay. Then it is not simply that you go and check and change it. No, you are not allowed. There will be committee who will assess that what is the load, what is the stress of this particular event, how many things we need to be changed, whether that whole circuit was okay or not okay, otherwise it should be changed, it should be removed. So that type of problem we face because we have no end later on. Okay. Similarly, at that point I will tell you that all the electronics component, first of course, we develop prototype model. And in that case, what happens, you can use the simple component. But the later on, it should be space qualified. And the other story was this, you have a logic later on in the circuit. Here you are dividing that put something in below 10 or below 10, millivolt I am talking about. And you are then putting into the different category. Okay. Now in that case, what happened? Suppose I have a multi-level amplifier. And the first one has a error of something like 1 millivolt higher. So you know next will be multiplied. And that range will go somewhere else. So all these things we have to take care of when it comes to electronics. And then photo communication, of course, when we say what is the data, what data has to come in communication, various modes from science wise. So science is one thing, but other the engineering thing we have to do. So the earth got that voice, okay? So I'm not going to other one like background in those things, that is more like things. So this is what I was talking about. We have a three flight thing. This is one, this is two, this is three. This is completely independent. Okay. Now, even in this pressure crossing electronics, particular one, important card, they are double within the card. If anything happens, there will be, we will switch on the level. And even while we are doing testing, I will show you the test. We do one by one, but we do very fast. So a little bit fast I have to move, okay, because I was going to make it popular, but I have to go a little bit faster than this. This is the basic concept of the business detector. You have a big collimeter, that is what we need to point to a particular source, and then this is the large detector. And this detector is the largest in the world,
that was the Chulin. So Chulin is coming from the size. Then also coming from the, this is roughly something like 1.2 meter. Okay, and width is something like 0.5 meter. And we also wanting to have a gas, this is a gas culture, at 2 atmosphere. So here the pressure difference is 1 atmosphere and 2 atmosphere. So it is fine, but in vacuum, it will be 2 atmosphere because the outside is 0. So leak chances are very high and we have to test it thoroughly during last 3 years. So we should have a record of that, okay? Otherwise you cannot do. So these are the basic concept. Moving part, of course, we don't think. This is just photograph of the main thing, so I will not touch much on this. I would just like to. This is really the front end electronics, first level of electronics. And this has to be very close to the detector. See what happens, this is the detector spec plate. And this is the single detector I'm talking about. So this whole instrument has 140 electronics card. So we have a large team of engineers, okay, who should work on this, simulate on those things. If any problem comes, we have to do systematic. And this was the thing. And why we keep on the back of this? Anybody can say? See, signal is produced in the detector. And we want, why we have to put it just on the back of the detector this. As you increase the length, you know noise will increase, right? That's how the resistor will go high and high, you will be having problems there. So that is the reason. So now, this is what is about crossing electronics, that was the front-end electronics, and each is 10 layer card. And those will be space qualified. And this is also the first time we are doing, because this is first time mission in India. We want very high precision type resolution. I will tell you in my whatever secular level why you need that, but why it is important. So here, basic challenge in electronics, besides whatever I told you, there was also a challenge in the sense that our operation range is something good, like volts high. You know, can you imagine one orbit, what would be the temperature variation? Can you imagine anybody? See, when it is sensitive at 600 kilometer, it can be something like 50, 50 or 60 degrees. But when you are in opposite side, it can be minus 40, 50. And this minus 40 plus 40, 50 to minus 40, 50, you are getting in how much time? 45 minutes. So that is huge. So even your mechanical system, your electronic system, there is a lot more stress. That's why we do extensive tests. We change the temperature that fast. So external test you have to do. And the story is this, once you do the test, any failure, that failure takes more time than doing any test. But the whole analysis, whole series is done. So this is what I'm telling you, one picture. This is the director, KFR, previous director. So this is the last three change. So this is the last change we did it in September 2013 and shipped to ISEC. ISEC is there, this is a ISRO center. It is a huge vacuum chamber, other vacuum chamber where we can put whole thing inside and then we can test. So the whole thing has to go there and then we do the test. And final calibration also do inside the vacuum chamber only. So these are some tests. So this you people may be knowing. Okay. This is all mostly electronics. Okay. We have to see from your instrument any EMI or EMC is disturbing others, or others is disturbing you. Okay. Whether you will survive in thermodynamic or not. Vibration, of course, will be there when you are launching. So whether they will survive or not, or anything will break. So what you do before test, study the performance, and after the test, you study the performance and see what is. Then once this is done, then full chain, of course, or that full chain, I mean the detector and the electrodes. You cannot have electrodes on the other chain and put into this one. You want that to work whatever you put up. These are the restrictions on the things, okay? Now, so these are the milestone for us. In 2013-14, we shipped most of these detectors and qualified into last year, all of this. That is, I'm talking about our instrument level. So once they are there, this year, it started all the payload they reached, other payload also. Then they integrate into single satellite. The concept of single satellite is like this, the power will come from single satellite. Then the Airbus computer, all this is connected with that. They are not individual, your computer will not be connected. So they integrated all the tests while done last year, and this year we have done all the tests at integrated level. That is started something like March. It is a very slow process and you have to do one by one. So by May it was integrated, tested, and you know whatever problem we face when we switch on. One of the S60, when it was switching, they were doing electricity, we switch off, you can click the command or you can run something, but when they were doing SFC, other command was not working. So there was a parity problem. Same detector, individually it was working, but then put into integrated, it is not working. So there are many things which comes at satellite level. That is from electron's point of view. Now this is the combination for checking EMI-MC test, all this. And this is in the vibration level. You have to vibrate all the axes in the at very high level. And this is Thunderbird. And we are doing this calibration. Calibration has to be in vacuum. There is also a genius challenge. What we want to do, we want it to automatic system which we can control from outside. You are putting your system into it from over there. The vacuum is there to become analysis. And you want to operate all this, move around the source, all the various axial sources, move in combination one or all or more, and steady. It can all of other things that was done by engineers. And this is what is the final picture. So when you go in AIT, that is creating, this is what is happens. You have to go like this, there are no first particle and those things for that creative problem. So now, this is what is the alignment. We are again, this is mechanical engineer, okay. Why the alignment is very important, okay. We are talking about this whole satellite, something like 3 meter by 3 meter, right. We are talking about the particles, this detector is 1.2 meter by half meter by half meter. Now, you are looking at somewhere, okay, something like, in our galaxy. 20 per sec, 12 per sec, 10 per sec, I'm talking about it to 18 or 19 centimeter, the type of distance. You want some that I can look only within a degree. But distance is huge. So alignment is very, very important. And what type of alignment we want here, you will be surprised, you want harmonic. Okay. With such a system, it is very difficult to get harmonic. Because the bulging, machining, you want, there will be some micron level problem. Okay, so that micron level, when you are putting two surfaces, there will be something. Then your mass distribution, all the, you have to take care of that models. Okay, and to achieve this, in fact, this is done now. Now I know the final figure. They have achieved this alignment within 2.5 minutes. And that is also achievement in itself. And this is the picture of the whole satellite. It will look like this. And this is a picture I made this year. Okay. Some of the picture, I'm sorry because I cannot, as I said yesterday, I was in Bangalore. I cannot really revise this talk because new picture has of course come. We have done the test now. But these are some of the other things, a few things only I could check and change. So these are the 3 detectors. This is the whole system. The solar panel is not yet mounted. Now, of course, it is mounted. I am talking about mid-2015. Now, this was the things when weather happens. I think this space I wanted to show you. This is Mr. Annadurai. You might have heard about Mars mission, okay, or Mangal mission, all those. You are the judge. Now, of course, he is director of ISAC, one of the big ISRO satellite center. So we are discussing on certain problems, there was some problems. So every time there is a problem, there will be a meeting like this. Okay? It takes a lot more time. And this is the recent meeting, 15 minutes. Last time when we have in Syria and Kota.
2 to 3 weeks back. And after the final test, we have a discussion and we sort it out whatever the things that we were talking. Final meeting, of course, with all divisions of the team that is clear about this. Something I will tell you that is again connected with, I'm not really touching science part, okay? Because we love to talk science, but I'm deliberately not doing science. But something we don't do from a hearing point of view. You have this type of pool table, like this, our instrument is like this size almost. Now I want the collimator, you have made a collimator, that is something like 40 centimeter, and their shell size is 6 millimeter by 6 millimeter. It is designed, it is indigenously designed in India only. We have not imported from India. I want to know what is the accuracy of my design. Okay, so how to do this? I gave you that there was an automatic, we have a scanning source device, we moved around and we illuminated the source, and this is the source of how it changes. This is all indigenously done. From there I can calculate power spectra, you might have seen for your transformer. So power spectra, this is the cell site, it should come exactly cell site where it is. And it should be Gaussian. If your thing is there, that you have the whatever you have made the polymeter is fine, it should be Gaussian like this. Okay. So these are the test done later on, or for the engineering model, whatever you do. And then there is any blockage or anything, you can check all those things. This is little bit, so I will just touch, this is science part. Once we have done the instrumentation, we do simulation. Simulation is the physics models, where you have a model of whole upper detector, what is the size, what is the gas, what is the pressure, and what is your energy coming from various things. And then you compare what you observe. When you put the source, get from model, get from here. So here, this is, I normalize only, this is total flux is coming at 60 kV and 30 kV. Don't bother about what I'm saying. You just take like these figures, these two figures. And then different layer, this would merge automatically. There should not be any parameter. And it is not easy job until unless you have a kind type of model. So I will not touch too much on this, but it is a big model. And similarly, this is available. So probably I will tell you only light story of this. This is something power spectra we are doing. Because we have very time, very fast time resolution, some 10 microseconds. So why we need it? Let me put in a popular way. Because this, if I start calling for it, it will start sleeping. So see, what happens, when you say very bright source, how fast you can cross, if any variation I want, how fast it can. Okay? It is, I can suppose that variation can move by velocity of light. You can't move more than that. So I calculate whatever the width divided by the light. Okay, that gives me the time frequency. And that, so if I have a efficient disk in black hole, the hotter one can move faster than other. So I can study the different portion from this time, which is moving fast, which is changing fast. So that's why this series, for scientists, energy is as important, but time is also equally important. Because different segment I can study. So this is what we finally achieved. What we are talking about, alignment can be done in dark minutes. And in all this, whatever we have achieved, this is better than the previous one. So I will not tell you this way. The two things which I am telling you, this is the structure I am talking about energy. This is the, it is like we will come very standard source in the spike crane. Exactly, okay. So you forget about it. You assume some sources there. It's a one upon 1,000 we can study in few minutes again. So that much is the sensitivity of this particular data. Okay. And I am comparing this is NASA satellite, LexPC. This is LexPC ours, and this is RXT is NASA's one. It is very much better than this. And this has been the most successful mission in the world during last 10 years. So this is what we expect from science, we expect much better from that level. So this is what I will put this, probably you will understand a little bit. Effectively, we will talk about whatever the best detector, okay? And energy, of course, we are talking about where we are important. All the things, solid line is the previous or the current mission in the world. European in America. Okay. And this is red is what is our subject. Dotted line will come out to 924. So that's why I was saying that this is the largest sensitive detector in the world and will remain so to study these compact objects, black hole and neutron star. So I'm a little bit now taking because now I have to go fast also. In compact object, basic things, many things you can do. As I promised you, I will not go in too much in physics. So I will just talk about by simply scanning, you can discover new sources, and that we will do. And when in a galactic galactic center, in our galaxy center, towards the center of UC in the night, there are material sources. So once any of the mission in the world, when they scan, a new source comes, it picks the name of that satellite. So we expect from this, especially from our detector, we should be able to discover many of the new sources during its lifetime of 5 years. So this first concept I will give you like this, this one I'm talking about. It is like you have a black hole somewhere and it has a competing star. You assume some, for some reason mass starts but doesn't fall here but accumulates somewhere in the middle. And once it accumulates up to certain level, then it starts falling and then it starts rising like this. Then what happens that when mass was not falling, there was no light, no X-ray was coming at that time, it's zero. Okay. When mass starts falling, goes high, maximum, it comes back. This is what they call outburst. So many of the physics, I will just talk about popular level. That is what, so this was the discovery from the IXT, American satellite. We expect better than this, from this one. And this is by some black hole discovered by that satellite. We of course expect many more than this. And this is little bit, so I will not go to physics of this. But what I will say, during when it goes high and low, there are somewhere radio, and somewhere in the highest system in those things, we will be able to understand better because our instrument has better capability than this. I will give you some picture and also how it is connected with radio. So I'm just rushing through this. I don't want to go into this part. Okay, I will come back to you. So this is the one I in the beginning my introduction. This IXC. This is what we clearly discovered with IXC. This is IXC picture. This is from our own instrument in 1997. Okay, and just you can compare this with like similar one. Now such type of, there are only two sources discovered. We expect you will discover many more sources in this. And what is this? So this type of layer we are talking about. To give you the concept, you are at your level where I need not to adopt too much physics. It is more like a cloud. This is the disk which was radiating in X-ray. When cloud is large, it reduces the flux. It is like cloud, sunlight is coming from top. If cloud comes between, what will happen to you? You will not get the sunlight. So similarly, when sunlight is there, you will see like this. When sunlight is disturbed by this cloud, it becomes like this. So those clear, and but you have to do a lot more things to understand this physics. So I promise you that I will do as popular as possible. So this is the one thing. Remember, in this case, there is no jet. Jet has no power, which goes very high, which I was talking about in the galaxy. But these also produce the jet. So this is what the jet has been observed in one of the sources. This is this black is the X-ray. This is infrared, and this is radio. Okay. Now, instead of doing this, I will tell you what is happening in the popular way. So again, that cloud earlier it was cloud coming and just going there, so like this. Okay. But here, what happens? This cloud in equivalent flux is low here. Okay. But here, cloud will disappear. This, and this is gone. It is jet is producing all the time. Mass is, but energy is so much distant from mass. And after that, it is on off states. So previous one, it was cloud appearing disappearing. Here, cloud is being thrown like a jet. Okay. So that is the, this is the most popular I can do. I mean, okay. If I would have given more time, I would have done differently. But this is the basic concept. When you think about these are massive things and they behave like this, there are plenty of such things. You also observe this thing. You might have heard about GMRT in Pune, right? NCR and GMRT is a huge radio telescope. Okay, and they observe these radio jets. Okay,
So basic concept is this. We were studying the concept from there, and with the associate also, we will be doing ground measurement with the radio. Now here, to give you at air level, so this type of thing we see, it is like this at certain wavelength. So what happens when you start at 0 with infrared, we were saying, first you see the radio, okay, at 15 megahertz, frequency is highest, then it reduces, reduce to wavelength is increase, right? Now, if I put it into the popular thing, what it will look like this, you are throwing the disk gap. Now this cloud is expanding, okay, with time. So when cloud is here, like when it is small, okay, it is not transparent. It can only radiate from the surface, like sun. It cannot radiate from inside. All the radio which is gone, it is not transparent. So it, as it becomes transparent to different wavelength, they will come. So first higher frequency will come, higher frequency, then lower and lower. It is just expansion, and then it becomes transparent to various wavelengths. Okay. So this is the popular level, like we talk about science here. And of course, then the comparison between the jet and with the galaxy, and in our galaxy, in outer galaxy, galactic center, we have millions or billions of solar mass. That both thing, both the system, both black hole system can be studied very well with this associate facility in multi wavelength, and we expect a lot more science. And without taking too much, I think I will just tell one more thing, maybe interesting for you. Black hole, we don't have really magnetic field too much. But neutron star, it has a surface, right? It's still left, and neutron star is still has a surface, black hole has no. In neutron star, there are very high magnetic field, 10 to the power 12 watts, and that produces the light. And that line would be studied from this master set. And from that, what does it mean? We are calculating the what is the magnetic field of various systems. There are many things, QPOs and those things, I don't want to go. So I think I will just finish here. If you have any particular topic you want to talk, I will talk about that. But basic part is this, the oversight, the instrument is qualified and all secondary level test is done. And now final test is also given. Yesterday it was clear that it's support for launch. So there is no now. And the capability of this is an indigenous instrument and developed completely at TFR, and it is world class laboratory. And of course there is a very large number of very large team, okay, it is not few people, okay. So there is very large contribution here comes from very large team, and we have a lot more support from ISRO Bangalore. This is so satellite efficacy science job. And there are many other centers of ISRO, we have a particular support for last something like 5 years or so. So thank you very much. So whatever question you have or something I can talk about. Thank you.
Now we have a question and answer session for the next half an hour. Those who have got any doubts regarding the session can raise their hands. We will take several time to clarify your doubts right now. Any questions regarding this session?
So when people come for interview, okay, when people come for interview, like either post or something, various things, we ask them what you know. They say, I'm very much interested in astronomy. So of course the next question becomes, what is in astronomy? And that is black hole. But after that they don't ask anything, okay, or don't tell anything much. But it is interesting subject, okay, that we okay for science.
Thank you. So can you talk more about active galactic neutrinos, AGNs?
Right. So AGNs, if you say the difference between AGNs and see, these are very, you will be surprised with the simplicity. Okay, because he has asked for this AGN questions. What we are talking about, the in our galaxy, we have a black hole, which is few stellar mass, say 10 solar mass. Okay. Now, AGNs falls in the category where billions of solar mass. That particular black hole has billions of solar mass. So then what will happen? So first, I think I should give the comparison of that. Can go back, right?
Yes.
Do not worry. Go back there. So basic difference comes. Or what is the simplicity of this? I want to go back. This is the last slide. The basic difference comes length and time is proportional to the black hole mass. So I have a system here. Yeah, that's it. So if I have a system. Right. So this is what I was talking about. You can think about this is quasars or AGNs you can talk about. So this is what where you have a mass of something like the black hole, that black guy sitting inside is billion solar mass. Here it is still a mass black hole, so 10 solar mass. Okay. Now we talk about the mass, the time is proportional to black hole mass. So something happens here in 1 minute. It will take thousands of years here. What does it mean? Suppose I want to study some phenomena, some jet is forming or something. I may do in few hours. But here I will take something like 10,000 or more years. Okay. So now since this question was asked, that is the one. Comparison. Otherwise, they also produce jet. Length will also be there corresponding to this whatever energy you are putting. Again, it goes in very, it is only 500 per sec AU, but this goes in through per second, so crosses the galaxy and those things. So that is also proportional to the mass. So I will now, in fact, because since this question was asked to me, I will ask you back one thing. Remember, so far, this is a new phenomenon. People want it only 20 years. It was not known earlier much. Now, this is known for 30, 40 years. Suppose you have that like this situation where each phenomena, like jet forming or jet is formed, is moving, continue for 10 volumes of years. How you will study such systems? See, our life. Life scale is something like 100 years, right? So 10,000 things I want to study. Its life scale is something 10,000 or more. How will you study them? Anybody can tell that?
We will be looking back and we will be looking back some years, millions of years, because light also takes that much time to travel to Earth.
True. Yeah, true.
So basically, then we can see over a period, like we can observe those radiations coming and then we can calculate it. At that time, if this is happening, then what will be the state today or 10,000 years?
Yeah, that is, you are right. You are saying about whatever I am, that is another concept that whatever I am seeing today, light started something like thousands of years ago. Okay. But what I am saying is, I want to study those systems and I want to see what is different stage. Because if I take only one system, I need thousands of years. Who will sit here on thousands of years, right? Nobody will give me salary, right? So, what to do? What to do? So, there is another concept. Then there is another concept that you take large population. And they will be definitely in different stages of the evolution. Okay. So this, so AGNs mostly, most of the things AGNs are coming from studying the large population of the Earth and studying how they behave in different stages. Otherwise, that is the biggest problem. You cannot really go for one single system and you want to see very precise. So by doing with the large sample, what was our procedure is not a good idea to do this case. But so far, so indication is like this, really nothing changes. You are going from 10 solar mass to billions of solar mass, everything working, whatever we calculate, like from gravitational theory and those things, perfectly matches. And that is really very surprising. It is really very inspiring. So anybody has any other doubt?
Sir, in this extra
sector,
so
TRPAN and
so many other agencies are involved.
So
how much engineering work
TRPAN
has contributed, all the scientific work?
No, we have done all the engineering work.
Okay.
It is done everything, whether it is mechanical, electrical, electronics, communication, everything is done for this, the largest instrument in TRPAN. We have, of course, get the help in there is any problem happening to the card level when we were working on this. And this is 10-layer card, in, you know. And the problem happens when we go in Thermovac. Thermovac is a 2-meter chambers, and that can be used by multiple people. So when we go there, we have to have a very large cables in our control center. Okay. Now, you have a certain tolerance in your electronic circuit, right? That is what you have developed. Okay. Now, this parasite capacitor will come into picture. And I am talking about 10 microsecond resolution I want. So that creates a lot more problem there. So you deliberately, in the beginning itself, you keep that much tolerance that this much parasite capacitance will come there. So that, like that, there are many issues. You are working, of course, with 24 megahertz clock. And at later stage, since launch was coming, we have to reduce the speed of the clock. So all, everything developed. We, of course, go for the technology which is tested. I'm talking about electronics, whatever ICs or the okay, you are using. We go, of course, which is tested in this space. But some part we do keep gradation, higher one, okay, better one. So many of the things are successful. At that stage, we have to have suggestion from various other institutions.
How do you separate this X-rays from other like noise? Because maybe they will be in very small values.
Right.
So basically, how you separate them from noise that's communicated with the
Other way around. I can put this question like how you reduce the background. Okay. I am looking for this light bulb. Okay. I want only light from here. Nothing else. Not that tube light, not that beam light. So what to do? So one thing is, of course, the collimator I was talking about is a big thing. Okay. So you such do in such a way that light will come within say. Suppose this is, I'm looking at it around maybe 0.1 degrees. Above 0.1 degree, whatever coming more than this, 0.2, 0.3, whatever, light will not come. It is, my collimator is like there is a shell, and that light can penetrate. Okay. So that will reduce this. Okay. So that is one thing, but probably I can little elaborate this. But even if I have with that one, I don't want charged particle. Charged particle may also come and produce ionization. So then there are major other concepts which we use, which is new development. The scientist has done a new development. The charged particle has more energy. It will really, we have a shell of detector. The total size of the detector is 15 centimeter deep. Okay. On all on three sides, we have a P2 layer. Anything comes, it crosses the P2 and then comes to the reflector, it will reject. Just to reject the background. Okay. Now, even if it is coming from top, if particle is coming and I have a cell from one, this is the size of the detector cell I am talking about, not collimator. Collimator has come, somehow it has come, whatever reason. Now, if this cell interacts here, produce something, signal I got, also producing the next cell, I will reject. Because this is charged particle. So there are various concepts which we developed to reduce this. So in fact, as a matter of fact, this black hole things and many of those things are very, very interesting nowadays from science point of view. So there are really great interest, of course, in India itself, but even outside, but there will be no other detector of this caliber in the world in the next 5-10 years. And we have many proposals from outside, especially US, I am talking about. They would like to collaborate on this, whatever science.
Sir, I have a question about black hole. Suppose I'm standing far apart from a black hole, and but it goes into the black hole and it crosses the event horizon. Then how would I see my friend? Like, he stands still over there, or he just disappears when he crosses that event horizon?
If you have crossed the event horizon, of course, no information will come. Really, we don't know. Okay. So nothing will come out. Okay. Nothing will come out. At that level, if you are talking about, since I was mostly talking about at popular level, science, I was talking about only popular level. Neutron star has a surface. Okay, not even for you. And neutron star, because inside whatever is happening, whatever current may be there, there is a huge magnetic field. Something like 10 with power 12 Bosch. It is huge. Okay. You will expect, or anybody will expect, in black holes should also be there. Okay. So far, whatever we have studied black holes, not much sign of the magnetic field. Now, even maybe whatever mass goes into after event origin to the black hole, the whatever current or whatever things may be there, but it doesn't come up. Because we don't, if that effect is there, we should see outside. If you will have understand the concept of black hole, because I thought some of the people will ask me, if that is the case with black hole, then velocity of light, nothing can escape, then why we get this X-ray? Do you understand this part? See, it is coming from beyond the event origin. Nothing comes with this. Okay, where is the efficient this? That is indeed very far away. But still energy is sufficient to get million degree temperature. And that's why X-ray is coming from that region.
Sir, I have this doubt about the communication of satellites. So, like, take an example, like we are sending a satellite to Pluto or any other at a distance of 0.1 light year. Just take a case. Now, during the launch, after the launch, there is continuous communication with the space station here. So, as soon as the distance increases, like from 0.001 light year to 0.1 light year, there should be a continuous communication, but when, like, on the process, the distance is also increasing. So that means the time taken for the signal to come from the satellite to the space station will increase. So how is that continue be maintained?
That's true. That is true. This Pioneer 10 and 11 launched in 1975, right? They traveled almost beyond the solar system, right? That is the farthest one.
Yes.
Of course, you need a deep communication system for that. Okay. What they call it, most of these things comes from, of course, because scientists are interested in something else. Okay. So, reason is this, how to reduce the noise in the signal what you are getting. So, there you should have larger antenna. Like for our moon mission, 32 meter large antenna was made, right? They have a special dedicated thing for that, okay? Even for moon, okay? Which is just not very far away, it's close to us. So what they do then, you have the few multiple antenna. They put in the orbit also radars, okay? From the interference, they will reduce the noise and then make it better. Of course, communication capacity, of course, decreases with that. That's why you cannot fly very large, those things. If you are talking about very beyond solar system or those things, but the techniques are there, right speaking. But you need few stations. For example, even right now, Associate will be launched on 28th, okay? So Bangalore will be one station, okay? That will also be little complicated in the sense you are supposed, this is the Bangalore station, my satellite comes on this, it will be equatorial, so it will be looking this side, right? Now, this is south, right? I believe it, okay? So if it is south, it will look like this. Now, total visible time is something like 12 to 14 minutes. Okay, 90 minutes is the sort of follow time. Okay, 90 minutes it will take 1 hour. So if you sit like in control room, you will see we have all this various satellite, India satellite, right? Every half an hour one satellite comes, okay. Every 10 minutes, 5 minutes, okay. Some are takes 24 hours, but some in 90 minutes all this will come back. So for launch time, now you are giving the command at that time. You are switching on something. And we want to be very careful. So first, whenever I switch on, suppose I switch on, this is my computer, I want to switch on. I want to see whether window comes or not. So I should know within that 12 minutes. So for that, then they will provide us to more stations. And like initially, like there will be one Mauritius, okay? There will be one in Andaman. There is another one, there will be hiring. So for initial phase, something like 1 or 2 months, we have 2 stations. Even here we have that.
Sir, could you talk about the software part of the project?
Okay. Yeah, software is the one. The software is really very challenging for us because it is the science part. So software is at 2 levels or 3 levels, but it is of course coming from the satellite. So you have been lots of information, estimating that whatever satellite is sending the information from there, you are getting the light, some information, but you should have the mechanism, various tests to find out whether data is usable or not, or you can make a study. So that we call zero layer. Okay? No. This is the raw data is coming. So first one, the raw data you are getting. After correction, whatever the loss and those things, that becomes the zero level. After zero level, because many things are there. You have the size missiles, various instruments, that data all packed together, right? You will not do separate, that will be too much, you don't have that space. So all data will be packed, and it is coming from different instruments and satellite systems. Health as well as the science data. So that data is distributed in that format, at the raw level or zero level. Zero level will segregate this data. Okay? That they will segregate to each detector, whatever science, whatever the health, and the what is the satellite housekeeping for this one. So that is the now you want level one. So still your science data is still that it is all binary, it's files and whatever you decide. At that level, they will be going from 1 to 2, where you will start your detector's response. Detector's criteria, whether good data or bad data, or various type of data you may be getting. For example, let's see, if I'm looking for some black hole, I want a light curve to see. So that curve will come. Then I want the power series, okay, how power series is there, that data will be there. So that will be done from 1 to 2. Okay. So now, software wise, from raw to zero level, that is your responsibility because they don't have the people in their system. Now, from 0 to 1, their responsibility, but we have to correct, we have to send the suggestion what is wrong. So, that is right now going on, and we are very busy with that actual quality. So, that part is going on. Once that is corrected, so that type of thing you have, whether they have optimized or not optimized, there are many systems there. And that they are level 2 what we want. Okay, and that level 2, of course, this is the various engineers who are working on this, with close interaction with the scientists. That is SEM, after what is doing, but they are interacting with us. Here, what is the problem? Problem is following. we have the orbit of 90 minutes. So data will be dumped when it comes around Bangalore, when it is routine, not during the business, but in routine, it will be dumped when it is around Bangalore. Now, when next time comes, I should be able to analyze all the data and say that whatever right or wrong or anything will be stopped. There are certain things which we have to do. So that condition comes from the software. So it is in multiple pages, zero level wrong, zero level one, two. So that is one.
Some agents like all of us are radio sources. So, is ASUS are capable of explaining the true nature of all of us?
ASUS is very wonderful, not only capable, the best capable in the world. Capable. Okay. It has the bio energy bend, it has the imaging detection also, it has the time resolution also, and it should compete with any of the detector worldwide. It has that capability. There are many people that we have now, because launch date has come very close, okay? So we have a big competition that who should get what time. Even outside the people, their proposals are being processed. Of course, we don't want so fast, but there is a great interest in that. AGNs and the Blackboard system, just to get within the given money. Yeah.
Outside the event,
event
or rather, how does the mass
get
converted to energy?
This is, you are saying above the event horizon, right?
Outside.
Yeah, outside, right, right. Because outside, yes. See, what happens like, so you start from basic thing, right? We have certain orbits, right, in our solar system, right? So, Earth is there, right? Okay. The Mars is there, the Jupiter is there, there are certain orbits. It is not all arbitrary, right? It is with some velocity or something like this. So suppose you have a black hole and the accretion mass is falling. There are some stable orbit. But when it becomes the minimum distance from the black hole, it can no more rotate, it will fall. So that we call it the most stable orbit. That is the large stable, the last stable orbit with minimum radiation. Even the Orion is even less than this. Now, mass is at that orbit. Suppose even the Orion, I am saying some R, but R that is the radiation of that. Now, my stable orbit is usually 3R if there is no stable spin of the black hole. Then at 3R this mass, and if you calculate from the gravitational potential energy, it will be huge, million radiation. Okay, so this mass is in million degrees, it will radiate. Okay, and if you are asking me little more strong in the sense, is there will be any gravitational effect? Because gravity is a strong gravity. If suppose 6 kV particle is 6 kV X-ray emitted here, whether it will have some Doppler type of gravitational shift, right? People expect when, especially in case of spin one, even though there is a spin, the last orbit becomes around 1 hour. Okay, and at that point, they expect that the lower energy, especially, there should be a shift because it is a strong gravitational field there. So this energy should reduce while when they are escaping those things. That of course we need. Okay, so that comes from the concepts and various ideas. Okay, I am working right now also on some papers where one can do it. But basic idea really will come from where all people will understand. If a mass stable orbit is 3 hours or 1 hour. Okay. If I ask you and give you an exercise, tell me what will be the difference in the energy available for that mass. Okay. So Gm upon R is 1, while Gm upon 3R is other. So you know 3 times more energy. Right?
So if energy is more, you move from some other means, like binary nature, you know the black hole mass. Okay. Then if you are getting more light, you will say that this radius is not VIR. Okay. And then you will calculate the body display. So that is the one very obvious. There are other methods also, but that is the one. Without the chain graph, black hole that means. Yeah.
So we all would like to hear about the exact meaning of string theory. People say that the string theory, they say that there are 11 dimensions and we are living in a dimension which a 4 or 3 dimensions. So is there another string which may have 11 dimensions, or is there any other laws of physics working out there? So all these things are this true or
true by
the concept, or
is
just a concept?
Right now, the concept of force and string theory is more like theoretical subject. Okay. But whenever some new things comes, and you know theoretical concept, they really explain many of the things. So the one of the players which I showed you in one of the source. In our galaxy, when that is sold, it was of course explained by string theory. Okay, this is more like a theory, but really that does not prove it. Okay, in my opinion, at least. Okay, that is a theory, and people say it is the theory of everything or something like that. But the proof is not yet there. Yeah.
How we can detect the location of black hole?
Location of black hole, right? Yeah, there are various methods, okay. Now there are various methods of that, okay. Of course, it depends upon the system. Suppose you have a two satellites very far away, and they are observing both of them from interferometer. You can observe that. Okay, if you have something else, the black hole system, they are associated with something else also. There are some other system, and through the other system, one can really get the distance. Okay, there are various things like if you have a emission. Physics I'm talking about, you have various lines, shifting of lines, absorption column density. Okay, that's those things, those parameters are there, but can be different. Of course, the simplest one which I can tell you is this, if you have anything else, measure it now. Okay, suppose this is now September, right? And then where after 6 months? So, you know what I'm saying. See, where is that now? Because you are talking about the sun system which is in the sky, not connected to the solar system. So I measure it now, where it is looking. And I measure after 6 months. So what will be the two measurement? How much is the distance? 2 AU, right? 1 AU is the distance from the sun. Okay, that also gives the distance. Okay. But this particular method is applicable to close distance only, not very high distance. Similarly, there are methods. You got this point, right? What I'm saying. See, Earth rotates around Sun, right? It is rotating. So in September it is here, the Sun is here, right? This is I am measuring somewhere cube like right here, right? So I'm seeing this is at certain angle. And now I come here after 6 months. Now I'm the angle is changed. And I know this distance how much. So from change you can find it. Yeah.
Sir, could you explain what is the parameters of the variable star and how this will contribute to the research of the
Just repeat your question.
How will this basically contribute to the study of
capitalistically trading stars and basically what are they? Because they are like a new thing which we are just a few years back we have discovered that this anomalous stars. So how will this be? Because they X-rays the way that they are studied currently.
Right.
So could you?
They are important target for Lex Specie instrument, of course. They are important target. This type of anomalies, there is always, when you are in science, extreme behaviors are always there. So what you are telling me now for this, like this source, in 62, when Gaikoni sent that rocket, and he got that message in the sky, we have this big X-ray flare, okay? He didn't thought about black hole. He thought it is a big solar mass, sun type of thing, and X-ray will come. Okay. So these things, of course, there are many things we don't understand. But they come from the process. For example, even in neutron star, there are what they call it anomalous neutron star, where huge vertically, which should not be there according to theory. So of course these are the target to study, and science comes from here only. To give you one example, how if you think about that, the black hole in these systems are discovered because US or America wanted to study these things. It did not happen like that. Okay, once they realized, and most of the satellite went after that. Okay. That I am talking about 65 or so. Once they realize that by putting a satellite in the orbit with X-ray detector, you can also study any this nuclear blast, whatever you do for atom bomb and those things. They always produce X-ray. And so to look, US while looking for Russia's thing, Russia while looking for this, and both of them put the satellite. So this was done for that purpose, okay, for the defense only. Now, these satellites were moving around, and there are plenty, and of course they detect many of the things. They can tell that you have done this nuclear thing, and you are not supposed to do. There are entity. Okay. But with that many satellite, it was a huge detector. There was another thing come, like gamma ray burst, okay, which we don't understand. So what was happening here, it also happens in nature. So similarly, these topics, of course, they are very interesting. Right now, we don't understand, but we understand that this new detectors and those things do that.
Any further questions?
So now I would like to express our sincere thanks to Professor Lal for giving an excellent coverage to this topic. I also extend my thanks to Preeti Jani Madam, mentor of Stargazers, and also Priya Chholia, chairperson of Stargazers, for their enormous cooperation in organization of this event. Now we'd like to request Preeti Jani Madam to give a token of our appreciation to Professor Joyce Madam.
I really thank you, Professor Yadav, for giving the time for a very busy schedule and enlighten and encourage us by sharing his knowledge and experience with the astrocerts. We wish him all the best. This launch is going to take the next end of this month sometime. And we also hope so that India already sees something new life in this particular science horizon. I once again thank Professor Yadav on behalf of my all team members as well as the staff of SPOT. Thank you very much. So finally, it's my sincere duty to thank all of you for participation in this talk. Thank you very much and till the next time.